Hey guys, today we're going to be covering converting N64 Eeprom dumps for use in an emulator or in the everdrive. If you have not seen part 1 of this video yet, you'll have to watch that first, as that covers how to dump your cartridge saves to your PC. And today we'll be covering how you can convert your personal dumps, convert downloaded saves, and lastly, we'll be converting emulator saves so we can send them to a real cartridge. Okay, and before we get started, I'd definitely suggest looking at what Eeprom type your game uses by checking the link listed below. There are two main types, 4 kilobit and 16 kilobit. The smaller 4 kilobit saves are much more common and much easier to work with. The 16 kilobit saves can still be converted in much the same way, but may require a little extra work. Okay, so let's start with Banjo-Kazooie. This uses a 4 kilobit save, so it should be pretty quick. First, we'll need a save dump to work with. If you've not dumped your game already, follow the last video and save your memory card as a .n64 or .mpk file. Either will work just fine. Next, run the game with your favorite emulator, and once you get to the title screen, a new .eep file should be created in your save folder with the game's name. We'll need this for later. Next, go back and find your .mpk or .n64 memory card dump from the first video, and drag and drop it onto this website. I'll have it linked below. Once it's loaded, you should see a new GameShark cart save. So click the little download button to the right, and you'll get a new .note file. Now open this .note file with your favorite hex editor, I prefer HXD, and also load up the .eep file that we got from our emulator. They should both open in different tabs. And now a quick crash course on how to use a hex editor. Most should be pretty similar, but this is HXD, and I'll have it linked below. This may look a bit confusing at first, but it's actually pretty straightforward. Up here, you have tabs for each of your files. You can switch between them by just clicking. And here we have three sections. The top and left section are the positions of your data. An easy way to think of it is like a spreadsheet with rows and columns. Sure, that's not technically correct, but it's easy to remember and it works for this guide. The center section shows the raw data in hex format. And the right side shows our data in text format. Again, this may sound like a lot, but we're only going to be working on the center column today, so you can just ignore the rest for now. And we can highlight data by clicking and dragging over the raw code. And you may notice this box in the bottom right has changed to show a length. In short, this will just show how much data is highlighted, but it will be counting in hex, not decimal numbers. So it will go 6, 7, 8, 9, A, B, C. Don't worry, you don't need to know how hex numbering works for this guide. All you need to know is that hex numbers are different than standard decimals, so 28 in hex is not the same as 28. Again, you don't need to memorize any of this, it's just to get you comfortable using a hex editor. So now let's start editing. Alright, so 4 kilobit saves. First, switch to the tab that contains our GameShark.note file. This should contain a bunch of data, but the first two lines are our GameShark note header, so our emulator won't need these. Basically, the first line just says, hey, I'm a GameShark dump. And the second line tells the GameShark what game it's for. But line 3 onward contain our actual save data, and that's all we need. So in our .note file, in the center raw code column, start at the beginning of line 3 and start highlighting everything all the way to the bottom, and copy it. Next, switch to our emulators.eep file, highlight everything with Ctrl A, and select Edit, Paste Write. Don't use normal paste or Ctrl V. Now save the .eep file, and load up the ROM once more, and ta-da! Our emulator can now read the save file. Now for transferring emulator saves to a real 4 kilobit cartridge. Writing saves back is just as easy, but you will need an existing GameShark note for the same game. If you don't have a GameShark note for your specific game, just dump the save with the GameShark and extract the note just like we did earlier. Now with your hex editor, open up both your emulator save and your GameShark note. Now this time, open up the EEP tab, select all, and copy. Then go to your note and highlight everything starting with the third line all the way down and do edit, paste write. Now I suggest using the save as option so you can name it something different. This way you can easily tell what game this note is for. You can name it whatever you want, just make sure the name ends in .note. Now go back to the memory card editor website and refresh the page. Now you should have a blank memory card. Next, drag and drop that new .note file we just made, and we should now have a fresh memory card file with our updated save. And you can download this by clicking the floppy icon. and you should now have a new .mpk file that contains our emulator data. Now we're ready to write to our memory pack. Load up the adapter software, click Tools, and open Mempack Editor. Next, load up the .mpk file we just downloaded, and click Write N64 Mempack. Now transfer to save using your GameShark, boot up the original game, and ta-da! We now have our emulator save running on the original cartridge. Alright, now let's try a 16 kilobit save. They can be a bit tricky, but for the most part the process is the same. Just as before, you'll need to upload your memory card to that website and download your .note file. Then open up your emulator save and your GameShark note file in the hex editor. Now, if you look at the end of your save file, you may see a lot of lines contain a bunch of zeros, as shown here. This is just padding. It's not part of your actual save, but it still can be important. This actually exists on real cartridges too, but the GameShark will actually remove this from your backup to save space. Okay, let's try to import our data. Just like last time, on your .note tab, highlight everything after the two-line header, and copy. Next, switch back to our emulator save, and press Ctrl+A to select all, and paste write. Now our new save data should be imported, and if you scroll down, you should see the padding is still in place. Save this, and boot up your emulator, and everything should load up just fine. If that import method didn't work for you, you can try this alternative. First, find out how long your save data is. To do this, switch over to your .note tab, and highlight everything after the header. You may need to scroll down a little bit. Next, check the length down here. Normally it's 700 in hex. Write that down and copy the data. Next, switch to your emulator save and scroll down to the bottom. Start reading from the bottom up and look for the first line that's not completely filled with zeros or filled with Fs. Once you've found that line, start at the end and begin highlighting up. Keep going until the length matches the value we wrote down earlier. In my case, 700 in hex. Now make sure you do a paste write and save the file. Now start your emulator and the game should load up just fine. Now if you're feeling a bit adventurous, there is a third way. It may work with 4 and 16 kilobit saves, but I don't really recommend it. On your note tab, you can simply copy everything after the header of your note to a new file. Then simply save that in your save folder with a proper name, or just overwrite an existing save, and hey, it may just work. It seems to work a little bit better with 4 kilobit saves. I've tried some 16 kilobit saves, and some do work, but others fail. But I'd really say for either save type, I recommend using the manual methods we discussed earlier, as they seem to work better overall. Okay, now for transferring emulator saves to a cartridge. Unlike 4 kilobit saves, we can't always just copy everything. Like I mentioned earlier, the GameShark removes any padding from a save file, so we'll be expecting an unpadded backup. So we need to make sure we copy the right amount of data. So if your emulator save and GameShark note loaded up, we're going to use the GameShark note to measure how much data to copy. So switch to the .note tab and highlight everything after the two-line header. And write down the length. For me, it's 700. Next, switch to your emulator saves tab, and you'll have two options here. You can start highlighting from the very top left, line by line, until your length matches the hex number we were looking for. Or you can save a little time by clicking in the beginning, right before our data, and going to Edit, Select Block, then clicking Length, and typing in the number we need. This will automatically highlight all the data we need. But either way, you should have the proper amount of data highlighted. Now copy this. Next, switch back to our GameShark note, and we should still have everything under the header highlighted. If not, just go ahead and re-highlight. Now we need to paste write. And again, I'd recommend using Save As, so you can name it whatever you want. The rest of the process is the same. Make a new memory card, add the note we just made, export the memory card, and write it to the adapter, and finally, transfer it with the GameShark. Now let's give it a try. And here's our emulator save, working on real hardware. And the last thing we're going to cover is converting old Dexdrive saves. Here's a 100% save for GoldenEye, and it's in Dexdrive format, but it won't work on my adapter. If I load up the save in the online editor, we can see it has a comment on it from the Dexdrive software. Unfortunately, our adapter does not like these comments, so we'll have to manually remove it. If you don't see this comment icon, the save should work just fine on your adapter, but many older online saves have comments. To remove the comment manually, we'll first need to download the note, then open it in a hex editor. All GameShark dumps should begin with a line starting with 3BADD1, so anything before that is part of our comment. So let's skip all this text. Highlight everything starting with 3BADD1 all the way to the bottom of the file and copy. Next, make a new file and paste the data in. Press OK if prompted. And now we have a clean GameShark note file. You can save this wherever you want, just make sure the file ends in .note. You can convert this for an emulator using one of the methods we already covered, and loading this on a real cartridge is actually super simple. Reload the website with the online memory pack editor, load up our new .note file, and the comment icon should be gone, so we're all set. Download this new memory pack, and you know the drill, load it up in the mempack editor, write it to your memory card, transfer it to GameShark, and now you should have the downloaded save working on a real cartridge. So that's it. You should now be able to fully work with and convert Eeprom saves. This method is not perfect. For whatever reason, the GameShark refuses to dump file 1 on Banjo-Tooie. The other slots work fine, however. Some other games may have issues too, but most games seem to work alright. If you ever need a refresher on backing up N64 games and you don't want to watch this video again, you can watch my advanced guide. It's pretty much a mashup of this and the first video, but with much of the repetitive explanation for things removed. I really wish I could have found a working method for converting SRAM saves for emulators, but apparently the GameShark compresses those. But for now, you should be able to back up a large majority of the N64 library and play them on your favorite emulator or flash card. So once again, huge thanks to all the people who did the initial research for this dumping process. I'll try to link all my sources below. And special thanks to rapnet for making this great adapter. It's a super awesome low latency controller adapter that even supports direct access for emulators, so you can do some really cool stuff. But anyway, thank you all for watching, and I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye!